So let us now talk about data providers, how we provide data to our test cases. And before that, I would like to tell you that if you have any question related to anything that we have discussed so far, feel free to write to me at my email ID. You can find it easily on my channel, and do not forget to subscribe to it so that you can get more information about the live sessions that we conduct and the tutorials that we upload in this context. We are also targeting to upload some interview questions, and we'll also take up your questions and upload some videos for that also as answers. Also, we have started a Telegram group where you can directly contact me and ask questions. So here is the link and you can join us. So let us move on to data providers now. So we have seen that there was one option for @TestAnnotation, but this is actually not the annotation. This is just an option of @TestAnnotation. Data provider itself is an annotation that we have. So these two are linked to each other. We need to see how we use it. So first of all, I'll talk about data provider annotation. So for that, use data provider. And you need to import it like this. And if you again do not want to import all these separately, you can put a star here. So data provider is here, and you can create a method public. Do not forget that the return type of this method is of type object of two-dimension array. It cannot be int, void, or anything else. It should be of this format only. You can give any name to your method like this. This is giving you error because it is not returning something. So we define, let's say, a object a equals, I define two values, 1, 2, and let's say third one also, 3 values, right? And I return a. So this is a method that I have defined here, but I have not used this data in any of these test cases. So for sake of simplicity, I have marked test 2 and 3 disabled. I have marked them enabled false, and I'm running only test 1. Right? So here the option is required. We have skipped this option for @TestAnnotation. Now to link our test method with this data provider, we need to use this option here. This means that whatever data is being fetched by this data provider method, or let's say generated by this data provider method, is given to test methods by this method only. But to link them, we need to say here that for this method, data provider is this method. So the name of method you need to give here. Alright. Also, it is important that as an argument, you specify the object. So the method was returning an object of return type A. Here you are also passing one object, which is A, or you can use any other name also. And let's say you want to print this for all the times, for all the data when this test method runs. You want to print this A, but this A is of object type, so you cast it to int, because the values which you are going to pass on are of int type, let's say, because 1, 2 and 3 are of integer type. So I am casting this value to int and then printing on console. So if I run test class A, the data generated by data provider 1, 2 and 3 is passed to test method. So this test method will run first time, it will print test 1, 1, and then it will run again with the second data, it will print test 1, 2, and then test 1, 3. Let us see the output. It also says that 3 test cases run. Actually, there was only one test case which ran 3 times for different data. So test 1, output 1, test 1, 2, test 1, 3. So also you can see the method name 1 with argument 1, with argument 2, 1 with argument 3. 3 times this method run, and the result is pass. So that is how we use data providers. Now here we have generated this data in the method itself, but here you can pull this data from external files. You can use POI jars to import data from Excel or CSV files, or you can also use some other libraries to import data from databases, and it can be from other configuration files. So all you need to do is, whatever you do with your data, you just convert that into a 2D object and then return it. And whatever test method you want to link it to, in this option you provide the method name of the data provider. And it is not mandatory that you have one data provider in a class. You can have multiple data providers. For example, first test case is using data provider this one. Maybe that other test cases are using data provided by other data provider. So the name of data provider should be different. And for other test case, we can mention that for this, the source of data is the other data provider and not this one. So that is how we use data providers. In data provider, if we use this annotation, we need to define a method which returns a 2D object array. And we can pull this data from an Excel file, we can pull this from database, or we can create an object here in the method itself and we can return it. All the test methods which are going to use this data provider need to pass this option, that data provider is the method name which you are going to use. Also, in the method argument, you need to pass on this object which is returned by this method. And then in the format which you want to use, you can cast it and then you can use it. So if I run this, so with the three data inputs, 1, 2 and 3, all these three test cases will run 3 times each. So there are 9 test cases in total. Test case 1 with 3 data, test case 2 with 3 data, and test case 3 with 3 data. Now in this problem, we have created one data provider and we have passed it for all the test cases. Since we are passing it for all the test cases, it is kind of an overhead for us to pass on this data provider object and mentioning this option for all the test cases. So we are looking for some alternate where we need not do this thing, and we can pass on our parameters and run the test cases for all the data. So for that, we have another annotation which is factory. So we'll see how factory works. Before that, I'll clear out all the things that we have done for data provider, and I will also remove this data provider method. So we need something like this, and we want that we need not declare, we need not pass this variable A for all these test cases over and again. So for that, this variable A should be a class variable. Let's say public int A, and I create a constructor here, public A, for this class, and I say that this dot A is coming from the argument. Wherever I create an object of A, I'll pass on as an object, as an argument, and this argument would be assigned to the class member, and this can be used here. Now the point is, where do we have used this @factory annotation? So for that, we will create a new test class. I'll call it as runner, and in this class we use @factory annotation, and we will define a method, public void factory, and we return object new A1 comma new A2, right? And then followed by a semicolon. Here also we need new, right? Okay, so let us run this and see what happens when I run this. So you can see here, test case 1 ran 2 times, test case 2 ran 2 times, test case 3 ran 2 times. If we create one more, new A3, so the execution is same as we have seen with the data provider. But this time we have neither passed on arguments, we have neither provided a data provider, nor we have used the option for the @test data provider. So you can see we have used @factory annotation to provide data to all our test cases in one go.